I love the way I look now. I don't wear makeup because I love myself so much. I don't wear makeup because I don't want to give cancer to myself with the makeup. We all have a responsibility in the media to not publish pictures of women with implants and makeup. What are we teaching our children? It's
so,
a fake reality.
So आप अपने friends या जो colleagues हैं उन्हें भी inspire करेंगे इस तरह की मतलब जो आपका transformation है उसके लिए? Would you like to suggest your friends कि वो भी इस तरह से करें?
बिल्कुल. क्योंकि ये जो आप देखते हो TV पे वो सच नहीं है. सच क्या है ये पूछो. मैंने एक healing किया एक लड़की के साथ. She's a mother, 50 years old. She had implants. उसने मुझे बताया कि उसकी बच्ची ने उसको देखा, बच्ची ने बोला मम्मी मुझे भी चाहिए. This is wrong.
One more question, last question, कि अगर आपका transformation तो हो गया, why you felt the need to publicize and to come into media to talk about this, कि you have turned something else, like?
Why do I feel the need? Because if I left the media looking like the old Sophia, I still leave a legacy to young women of what they think a woman should look like. So I want women to stop this fake reality, stop living this false reality, you know. And the truth of this world is that we are in the Garden of Eden. You are born perfect. You are all perfect. You are children of God, every single one of you. You have been made to hate yourself, to judge yourself. You have been made to judge other people. You have been made to separate from others, from your religion. But we're all brothers and sisters, and the day is coming where you will wake up and look at a Muslim, look at a Jew, look at a Hindu, and say, that's my brother, that's my sister.
Any more questions?
Yeah. Sophia, your film came out, 6X, which was a very glamorous role. That film was written in Cannes. And now, you've been transformed. How did you promotion this film?
मैं फिल्म की प्रमोशन नहीं करूंगी. I wish that the film was not being released because ये जो फिल्म मैंने last year किया और उसका रिलीज का डिलेय हुआ और obviously in there I have a glamorous avatar, I have a love scene, it's not who I am anymore. The film is a good film if you want to say that, but I'd rather people didn't remember me as an actress and remembered me as the Holy Sacred Mother.
Okay, अभी आप इंडिया में जो आई हैं, तो आप गरीब बच्चों को मिलने वाली हैं, और आप जहाँ पे पानी बहुत कम है वहाँ गांव में जाके लोगों को मिलने वाली हैं, तो उसके लिए क्या तैयारी कर रही हैं?
अच्छा, मैं ये देखिए, मैं जो पैसे मैंने कमाया last year, I want to give that to, I'm working with an NGO orphanage, and also if it doesn't rain in the villages, मैं वहाँ जाऊँगी और I will take water, trucks of water for the children.
Thank you. That is
the prophecy is coming true in this age. In the next 2 or 3 years, all of the gods are coming back to the earth. The Holy Sacred Family are here. The gods are waking up. The angels are waking up. My incarnation is that God. Mother Mary, the goddess Isis, who are the same. Jesus is already here. My son is here. And in time, you will come to know who he is.
Do you know?
Yes, I do. It was him who guided me to who I am. But
and he's come here as Jesus himself.
See, the thing is, what you have been taught has been a twist of the truth. The gods have always been on this earth. The prophets have always been here, but we have forgotten because there's a program, a matrix of program that is programming you. You have three bodies. You have a physical, a spiritual, and an electrical body, and your electrical body is being programmed by a negative source, a negative energy, and negative power. They're programming you into what to think. They've already told you there's a hell. They've already told you there's a heaven. You're already in heaven. You're already in the Garden of Eden. The gods have already been here. But when this programming in your mind has been, you've been intercepted on who you really are. You've been told lies. You look at the stories of Egypt, they call the Egyptian stories a myth, the Greek stories a myth, the Hindu stories a myth, they're not myths. And now what's going to happen? The real cities of the past that you read about, the gods of the past, their homes are coming up from the ground.
Thank you. Photo. Photo. Photo.
Photo. You know, change is the rule of nature. So,
sorry, say that again.
Change is the rule of nature. Okay. आप जिंदगी तरह से transform हो चुकी है, बदल चुकी है. कितना बदल चुकी है आप? ये ना आपसे क्या बोला? किस बोला था?
Thank you.
Another question I want to ask you. Few months ago, even supported against of the war in India. मैं आपसे जानना चाहूँगा आपकी strong transformation के बाद भी आपका ये perception है किस तरह का?
No. Actually, for me, pornography desensitizes people. In fact, a lot of celebrities, whenever there's an issue, we put a picture up that we know is going to get some attention. Okay. Everybody does it.
So will you support?
No, because I'm celibate. I haven't had any physical sexual relationships since July last year, and I never will, because I am the Holy Mother. My womb is the fertility of this earth. Pornography only desensitizes people. We are in an age in our life where people are having more sex and more freedom. When I say freedom, what is real freedom, right? We think it's free to have a lot of sex. But we're also in a time in our life where there's a lack of connection.
So suppose in future, our government
bans
porn sites, so
will you support? Yeah, I would support the ban of porn, absolutely, because I don't want children to grow up. If you look at what's happening in America, children at the age of 10 years old are going for counseling because of porn addiction. And secondly, the idea of a woman and how she wants to be treated, people are thinking that's how what women want. It's the opposite of what women want. That's not how a woman wants to be presented. Again, we're going back to this fake reality.
Anything you want to apply to young
Bharat? Hey, bus kar sir. Mera ja chal. Bolo. Bolo.
So the last question. Vegan ho gaye ya non-vegan chhod diya hai? You're not using perfumes and all. So vegetarian hone ka what is the reason kya hai?
Sir, vegetarian ke baad kya?
Vegetarian hone ka reason kya hai? Vegan.
Acha. Yeah, I'm a vegan now. And the reason being is, when you come into consciousness, when you are conscious of who you are on this planet, and you're conscious to yourself and to others, you wouldn't eat anything that comes from an animal, because these animals suffer. You know, when you take milk from a cow, the baby is taken away so that we can have its milk. Animals were not put on this earth to be killed and to feed us. We're here to care for them and love them. Who says? You know, we all shout about eating dogs in China, but why are we eating cows? Why are we drinking their milk? Why are we killing other animals? I used to eat meat a lot. But since I became conscious, what right do I have to take away someone's life? What right do I have to drink milk? I mean, if you have a cow in your back garden and you milk him in the morning, that's fine. But these days, the commercial production of milk is hurting the animals, and it's not fair. And we all need to be conscious beings. If we don't look after ourselves, which we don't, we think we look after ourselves by wearing nice clothes and makeup and deodorant, but those things are giving us cancer. So I'm asking you all to look after yourself, really look after yourself, and really respect yourself. Know that you are children of divine gods. You are the children of gods. You know, I'm looking at you now, and it's like you're just human beings, but you're not human beings. This body is a vehicle on this earth. Your soul will go on afterwards. So look after your soul more than you look after your body. Because your soul is who you are, not your body. But we have been trained to focus on the physical.